So what's up mga kote, it's me Kuya Kyle and welcome to Quadr Knows, where learn is the name of the game. At kung bago pa lang dito sa channel, please don't forget to click the subscribe, like, and share buttons for updates and videos. So as in our introduction, makikita nyo naman, ang title natin is Parts of the Book. So sa mga parts of the book natin, madami tayong We have some 3 parts, and sa mga parts na yon meron tayong mga certain what do you call this? Para meron siyang laman ganun. Something na nakalagay doon, and some part siya nung body part na yon or something ganun, basta ma-discuss din sa inyo mamaya. Pero bago natin simulan yung topic natin ngayon, siyempre, alamin muna natin yung trivia natin. So, did you know bubble wrap was originally invented as wallpaper? So, naisip ko lang dito is, kaya siya na-invent na wallpaper kasi malambot siya. So, iwas untog siya sa mga hard surfaces. If you find popping bubble wrap one of the best things about getting mail, imagine it being plastered all over the walls of your home. Engineer Al Fielding and Swiss inventor Mark Chavanis invented bubble wrap by accident in 1957 while trying to create a textured wallpaper by sealing 2 shower curtains together to trap air bubbles. So grabe ang crazy ni Mark Chavanis. Grabe na yung bubble wrap na na-invent niya noong 1957 is parang sobrang useful ngayon, especially sa mga shippings natin, sa mga shipments, ganun. Sa mga parcels natin, 'di ba? Meron tayong bubble wraps para maging secured yung yung in order natin, 'di ba? So, sobrang galing ng invention niya, and as we all know, bubble wrap, parang pag meron tayong ganun, pinapop-up natin siya. And sobrang saya niyang paglaruan. Kasi bukod sa nakakalibang siya, naka-enjoy and nakakasobrang satisfying niya. Nakaka-relax siya ng utak. Nakaka-satisfy yun. Like, especially if na-stress tayo, ganun. Pwede natin siyang gawing simpleng libangan. Next up, we have our agenda for today. So, ang agenda natin is different parts of the book, definition of each part, and importance of knowing the different parts. So, first of all, we have here, as we all know nowadays, with the use of modern technology, necessary information can be accessed in just several clicks of the mouse. This may be one of the reasons why students tend to disregard one of the important reading materials, the book. So, through students, we now have easy access to information. Still, books can provide readers with stories, tales, articles, pictures, and information that outlive those the internet, which can be erased in seconds. So, books can be more appreciated in the reader as a good grasp of their parts, the front, the body, and the back parts. So, sinabi dito na, kahit may internet tayo, mas maganda pa rin yung information natin is nakuha natin sa book. Kasi, di ba minsan, sa mga, pag nagkakalap tayo ng information sa internet, nagkakalaps yung ibang mga ginagamit natin na apps, so hindi na save, pero pag sa book, safe siya, no collapse. Ingatan nyo lang yung book na yun. Hindi masunog or mabasa. So, we have here front part of the book. We have 3. Title page, copyright page, table of contents. So, in title page, it tells the reader the title of the book, the author or the authors, and the publisher. So, of course, mahalaga rin yung title page para malaman natin kung sino yung may gawa. And in copyright page, it provides the reader with the year when the book was published. So, this is known as the copyright date. It's very important to check this part to know if the information is recent or up to date. So ayun yung importance ng copyright page para malaman natin yung recent date niya. And in table of contents, it provides the reader with a list of units or chapters, the titles of the lessons, and the page of pages where you can find the topics or lessons. So ayun, sa front part, title page, copyright page, and table of contents. So sa body part naman, it provides the reader with the same content of the book, such as articles, tales, pictures, and all other information it can offer. So dito sa body part, marami dito information na makikita natin kasi ito yung parang main flow of the information where we can have knowledge about the article or the tale, and this part includes pictures and all other information it can offer. So ayun yung sa body part. Now we have the last part, which is we call the back part. We have three parts in this back part: the glossary, index, and bibliography. So in glossary, it provides the readers with a alphabetical listing of unfamiliar and difficult words and phrases and their meanings, which were used by the author in the book. So dito natin sa glossary mahanap yung mga meanings ng mga deep words na nilagay ng author para mas maintindihan natin yung specific word na narinig natin or nahanap natin. So second is index. So it provides the reader with the alphabetical listing of particular topics or names used by the author and the page or pages where they can be found. So here, we have the topics and names the author has used. So lastly, in bibliography, it provides the reader with the alphabetical listing of reference materials used by the author in the preparation of the book. So it includes the name of the author, the title of the book, the name of the publication, the place of publication, and the year when it was published. So what is the importance of different parts of the book? So the importance of different parts of the book is for the book to be organized, and it also helps the readers to easily find the information they want to gather. So that's all, guys. Thank you for listening, and I hope na may tunan kayo sa ating lesson, which is parts of the book. Again, this is Sir Kyle, and I'm signing out.